Skin bleaching, skin lightening, skin toning, as some people will call it, are all the same thing. The fact that you are using an ingredient, a product, to suppress the production of melanin and look lighter or brighter or clearer, as some people put it, that means that you are skin bleaching. There's no difference between them. I know some people think that when you say skin bleaching, that means it damages your skin. When you say skin lightening, that means you are not using very harsh products. And when you say skin toning, you are just using natural lightening agents. In as much as these natural brightening agents are organic, and some of them are used to brighten the skin, many of them are not used for the period of time that they are required to be used, and they are not used at the right dosage. So today I'm going to be dishing to you 26 facts about skin bleaching, skin lightening, or skin toning, as you may call it. Hello everyone, and welcome to my channel. I am Gwendolyn Halle, a seasoned and certified medical microbiologist from the UK, and I'm popularly known as the medical professional with the difference, because I make learning so easy from the comfort of your living room, and I bring you the knowledge like no other. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you. And if you just hopped on this channel, this is me telling you, you're welcome. Let's go there. Welcome back. In today's class, I'm going to be giving you some facts, 26 facts, and even more about skin bleaching, skin toning, or skin lightening. So, what is the danger, or what is the problem with this skin bleaching, skin lightening? Many manufacturers of skin bleaching products don't actually indicate the right percentage of the active ingredient on the packaging. Secondly, many harmful bleaching agents are not indicated on the contents on the list of ingredients. So you find that somebody takes a product not knowing firstly the percentage of harmful ingredient. It could be mercury, it could be cortisone, and then most times it's not even indicated on the package. So what am I trying to say here? Many manufacturers will take advantage of your ignorance, of your desperation or frustration to get lighter, and they will manufacture anything that will make you lighter even in 2 days, because your desperation to get light skinned is so high, you don't care about your skin. The skin is the largest organ. It has a lot of function. It's as important as the heart, the liver, the kidney, your intestines, your stomach. It's so important. And anything that you put on your skin, it's like a sponge, seeps down into your bloodstream. So there's nothing you can say it's only at the top. Your whole body is filled with pores, and these pores open 24/7. There's no day that your pores are not open. Either they are open to secrete waste or to secrete sebum. They are open, actually, and that is the natural functioning of the skin. Now, what we have that is so bad is, as an adult, you can let go of an adult, or you could say, oh, this is an adult. The person has a right to do what he or she wants with her body. But what we find is, you find adults who actually bleach their children's skin right from when they are 8 months, 6 months. And when you want to find out, they say, no, the one the child's original skin color to come out, they want the child to look fresh. The fact that many people think that you have to be light skinned to be beautiful, to be considered as someone who has a healthy skin or somebody who is taking care of their body, is mental slavery, mental enthronement. And it's so dangerous. So please, if you're an adult and if you want to bleach, bleach while listening, but cautiously, but don't put it on the kids, because there are some kids who have kidney damage already at very tender ages, because parents constantly put bleaching creams. When you see a mother putting bleaching cream on herself, she'll buy a tube that contains steroids and put it on a child that is so young. And some kids, when their immune system is not so strong, it damages some nerves, some organs in their body. It weakens their immune system even while they are babies. Remember that even hydroquinone, alpha-arbutin, vitamin C, glutathione are being medically prescribed for some skin condition. And even though they are not prescribed by medical doctors, every manufacturer, good manufacturer, knows that this product is supposed to be taken for a particular period of time and you stop. Hydroquinone is not a bad product, but it is prescribed only for a short period of time at a low percentage. It helps with dark removal of dark spots, yes. It helps with hyperpigmentation, yes, but it's only for a short period of time. Because if you take it for a longer period of time, you will make your skin thinner, you will have stretch marks and a lot more. So let's dive into today's class. And the first we have on our list here is cortisone. Usage of bad ingredients, for example, cortisone, that actually suppress the production of hormones responsible for ovulation. And this causes many women who bleach their skin, who lighten their skin, or who tone their skin to have fertility issues. Many of them find it very difficult ovulating and even irregular menstruation. Let me say this. Any ingredient or any bleaching product that you are buying, or any lightening or toning product that you are buying that has been indicated on, or that starts making you lighter in less than 2 weeks, there is a problem. Normally, when they say you're trying to even bleach the skin, even at that 2% or even at that minimal percent of hydroquinone, it is gradual. Any product that rapidly lightens your skin will damage your skin. And this is what I want you to put in your mind. Not only damage your skin, it will damage your internal organs. Very important. Take note of that. The second point is this cortisone and mercury will deform your baby. Many ladies who bleach their skin while they are pregnant, especially during the first trimester of their pregnancy, the early stages of their pregnancy, already deform their babies. I know you will say, oh yes, my first child I was lightening, but the child didn't come out deformed. Actually, you don't deform the child only physically. The internal organs may be defective or not function properly. The child's brain may not function properly. So please, if you are pregnant, stop it. In fact, if you know you're about to get pregnant, stop bleaching. Even while breastfeeding, stop using bleaching products. The third point is it damages the liver, the kidney, and the nerves. And this is for both little children that have been bleached by their parents. This is for babies in the mother's womb. This is for mothers themselves. It damages your nerves, your kidney, and your liver, because there'll be a lot of toxins in your system. Yes, the liver regenerates itself every time it detoxifies your body. But when the toxins are too many, you know, it instead causes damage on the liver. The kidney also, too much functioning, too much activity of the kidney would make it to stop functioning properly. And that is why you're always going to be in the hospital for one problem and another. And you know what is strange? When you go to the hospital, the doctor is not so quick sometimes to just tell you that it's because of the skin bleaching products that you're using that is causing you health problem. Apart from that, it weakens your immune system. Many people who lighten, bleach their skin, or use skin bleaching ingredients have a weak immune system. They are constantly ill, constantly in the hospital, constantly taking medication. The next point on list is high blood pressure. The fourth, high blood pressure. Ask around you, you will notice that a lot of people who bleach or lighten their skin are struggling with high blood pressure. That's because of this damage that is done by these ingredients in the blood. Remember, these toxins enter the blood and damage certain vessels, damage. In fact, they reduce the natural functioning of certain organs in your body, particularly the flow of blood, etc. the feed point, the skin becomes darker or too light. Now, you know what I'm talking about. A lot of people will say, I'm using this lightening cream to lighten my inner thighs, to lighten my armpit, to lighten my underbum. But if you notice, it instead becomes darker. There are some parts of your body that when you want to lighten, it instead becomes darker. Even this part. The instead becomes darker. Your neck becomes darker. Or you become too light. Skin. The sixth point is your skin becomes very thin and you are prone to wounds and slow healing. Many people who lighten their skin experience slow healing. That means if you go for an operation, trust me, it will be very difficult for the doctors to stitch your body. In fact, the stitches won't be able to stay in place because your skin is so light, so thin. And when you have a wound, it will be so difficult for the wound to heal. And why is that? Because these bleaching ingredients actually alter the natural cycle of the production of elastin and collagen that are very important for the elasticity of the skin, the strength, the texture of the skin, the healing properties, the healing function or the healing activities of the skin when we have wounds. So please bear that in mind. When you start noticing that your skin is becoming very thin and you can see your veins through your skin, know that you are in danger. Serious danger. And even when you have those sunburns, it's so difficult for your skin to actually repair itself because the elastin and collagen have been shatter that cycle. In short, you have very low elastin and collagen. The seventh is that you start seeing visible blood vessels on your body, which is very dangerous. You see a lady with red and green blood vessels, particularly on her thighs, sometimes at the back of her knee, sometimes around her arms here, sometimes even on her face, which is very dangerous. Now you see why it's very possible for a lady or a person who is bleaching their skin to have high blood pressure, because when these ingredients seep through the skin, they enter directly into the blood. And the eighth point is causes moles. You will see these little moles that people have on their body everywhere. That's caused by skin bleaching. A lot of ladies whom you see that are using, especially rapid bleaching, experience that. They have that a lot. Their skin produces it because the natural cycle of the production of melanin is actually altered. In fact, instead of producing melanin in all areas, let me say, for example, around your neck, your body finds itself trying to produce melanin on one spot because the cycle, the natural cycle of production of melanin has been altered. And also your body is trying to produce melanin because you are under the sun. Let me tell you something. The UV light is not only produced during the day. UV light is produced also at night, but at lower levels. So don't be fooled that only during the day, if I stay indoors, you know, I'm fine. As long as I stay indoors, I'm fine. And at night, I can go out. No, it doesn't work that way. And the ninth point is sunburn and skin damage. That is a very common fact, you know, with people who are lightening their skin. The reason why you have melanocytes producing melanin is to shield your body from this sun rays, this intensive UV light that damage your skin. And that is going to cause skin cancer or skin burns. So whenever you think about, you know, bleaching your skin, know that you are constantly going to be having sun burns and you are prone to having skin cancer or damaging your skin completely. You know what's funny? I have my albino friend who told me that he was wondering why people bleach their skin because he is struggling to protect himself with sun screens, with sun protection oils, And even when he went to Canada during the winter, he still has sunburns. So in an albino's mind, he's like, wow, this is really serious. Really serious. I've said this several times. The only people who are allowed to lighten their skin or bleach their skin are people who are already lighter skin. As long as you're a dark shade like me or darker shade than me, if you try to bleach your skin, you are just wasting your time. Your DNA will not permit you to enjoy even 1 month of good skin glow. Because as time goes on, your melanin, particularly if you're in a tropical environment like this, with high intensity of UV rays that are being emitted, your DNA will not permit you to just be without melanin. That is why many manufacturers will have to put high dosage of toxic, harmful chemicals in it to suppress it to a point where they damage your organ, they damage your skin. And for people who are lighter skin that want to bleach their skin, you have to do it controllably for a short period of time. You stop and then you continue. For those who have damaged their skin, you have at least 2 years to heal your skin and allow your skin to recover. Anything that lightens you rapidly spoils you faster. And the healing process is normally longer. The 10th point is steroid acne. You will notice that many people who lighten their skin have acne. Most times they have whiteheads, sometimes they have blackheads, and they have this oily face most times. It's like the natural cycle of oil production on the skin has been destabilized or altered by these toxic chemicals. That you notice that the person's face is constantly oily. They call them steroid acne or steroid pimples. Not only will you have whiteheads or blackheads, you have them being so big and so strong. And most of the time, they don't want to pop. They're just so big and they're looking at you, staring at you in the face. The 11th point is the skin becomes very oily, like I explained. Your skin becomes extremely oily and you wouldn't know how to control it because a steroid or an ingredient that you have used has damaged the natural functioning or altered the natural functioning of certain activities in your face. And let me tell you something, most people who bleach their skin look much older than they should be. You will find a 25-year-old girl looking like a 39-year-old woman. That's because the natural cycle of production of collagen and elastin and certain fine structures in the face have been damaged or altered. The 12th point is skin rashes. Many have skin rashes on their body. The 13th is hyperpigmentation and decoloration. Whether you are using a skin bleaching product that costs $100 or $200 or $300, $20 or $10, whatever the price range is, skin lightening, skin bleaching, skin toning is not good. It will damage you. They are the same. They have the same effect on the body. What am I trying to say? If you are taking a natural ingredient like glutathione, that our body even produces, and you try to put it on your body at a high dose, at a dose that is not required for a long period of time than required by the manufacturer. There are some skin bleaching products that cannot be used during the day, but are best used at night. So most times, that's the 13th point, you find a lot of people with hyperpigmentation and decoloration. You have a lot of people with dark eyes, their necks are dark, this face is too dark, in between their thighs is dark, their knees are dark, and a lot more. And let me say something, for those who bleach their private parts, because of high level of estrogen and blood flow towards that area, let me tell you, and the melanocytes around that area, your private parts are supposed to be darker than other parts of your body. It will even get darker when you are pregnant due to the high levels of estrogen. It will get darker when you're having an orgasm. It will get darker because there are more melanocytes around that area. There's no way you can bleach your nipples. And there are many who go around taking injections to get lighter. That's even worse. There's a particular amount of glutathione that is supposed to be in your body at a particular period of time. The 14th point is large stretch marks. Many people who have stretch marks that are caused by skin lightening, skin bleaching, or skin bleaching products find it very, very difficult to actually wear dresses that are very elegant, because the stretch marks are so big, they don't only cut across. The skin damage doesn't only cut across the epidermis, it goes through the dermis, through the fatty tissue, and right to the third layer of the skin. So that is why it's very difficult for it to close. 15, body odor. We know that these skin ingredients have a very pungent odor. Imagine when you mix it in a lotion. And not only that, when these ingredients come in contact with certain enzymes in your body, they actually release a fishy, pungent smell. And that is why many people who use these bleaching ingredients maybe don't even know that they have a funny body smell. If you're using lightening products, no matter, sometimes even the perfume you use cannot mask this body smell. It's so strong, especially when you sweat. Your sweat is so smelly and toxic, salty. That's because of the toxins that your body is trying to release so the organs can stay healthy. The 16th point is it gives dark spots, sun spots, freckles, melasma, and dark eyes, particularly here. What I'm going to advise, if you are bleaching your skin, wear makeup that contains sun protection factor, SPF. Wear a sun protection on your skin before you step out. I know most of you are going to say, oh, but this sun protection, or when I enter the sun, it's going to make me look darker. Yes, because it's absorbing the UV light, the UV rays, A and B. It's absorbing it so that it doesn't damage your skin. Don't let marketers or people who manufacture these skin bleaching products at the back of their house produce products for you that will cost you your life. Your skin health doesn't mean that you must lighten your skin. You must use skin bleaching products. Skin health means that you're able to maintain your natural color and look radiant and look glowing, because every skin tone can glow and look radiant. You must not look lighter to be radiant and glow. The next point is, 17th point is, it causes eczema and dermatitis. Many people who actually bleach their skin have eczema and contact dermatitis. Many also have psoriasis. They will itch, you find them with skin disease, a lot of skin diseases. The skin is struggling. 18, skin ulcers and cancer. If you wound your skin, let me say you're cutting things in the house and you have a little cut on your skin and it takes more than 1 week to heal, and it's up to 1 week it's not healing, stop the bleaching, because you are just exposed yourself to skin ulcers and skin cancer. Many people who haven't spoken to albinos, I have a lot of albino friends, you speak to an albino and they tell you how frustrated they get when they have a wound, an opening on their skin. How they do everything they can to never have an opening on their skin. Because once they have an opening on their skin, they are very prone to skin ulcers and skin cancer. The 19th point is exogenous ochronosis. This is when you see blue and black pigments on the skin. And it's very common for those who are taking hydroquinone, mercury, sometimes kojic acid. In fact, those people who are taking bleaching products that contain high levels of certain ingredients abuse the use of this natural lightening or bleaching or whitening agent. Remember, I said skin bleaching, skin whitening, skin lightening, skin toning are all the same. Whether you are black, white, Caucasian, from whatever race you are from, skin bleaching is skin bleaching. They are all the same. The 20th point is nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome is very common with people who are bleaching their skin. But the thing is, it's not easily diagnosed, because when they go to the hospital, the doctor will not do all the necessary tests to test their kidney to see what may be happening. Or it may not really actually dawn on the doctor that it's the products that this lady is using. When a lady has nephrotic syndrome, the blood vessels of her kidney are damaged. She has swollen feet, ankles, her ankles, her feet, these areas of her body are swollen. Most times you see her hands become swollen. And also she has this swollen area under the eyes. And she has a foamy urine, protein in her urine. That is how you know you have nephrotic syndrome. And gradually your kidney will fail. The 21 point is, it weakens your immune system. Your immune system becomes so weak that you are susceptible to a lot of diseases, and you are very prone to diseases. You are always taking malaria medicine, you always have stomach problem, it would affect your digestion and a lot more. The 23rd point is, there are some products, ingredients that are supposed to be used only at night. Skin bleaching is supposed to be carried out at night. Why during the day you use a natural product, avocado, something natural with your sun protection, and you use it only for a month or two and you stop? Then at night you may just be using a vitamin C or a vitamin A lotion during that time, and then after like 3 months or 4 months you can pick it up again. You don't use it for the rest of your life, because you would die early. That is how these things work. Don't be fooled that you can bleach your skin for 10 years and be normal internally. Your health, your overall health will be normal. The 24th point here is, this skin bleaching, skin whitening, skin lightening or skin toning springs from low self-esteem. I'm not here to judge or condemn anyone, but we are being thought that being lighter is beautiful. On the contrary, I have a lot of light-skinned friends worldwide who, when they meet me, they love my skin tone. They love that I am dark shade, but I have a radiant and glowing dark shade. So they're really fascinated and they want my skin tone. But I love their skin tone, but they want my skin tone. There are many people who are light-skinned who are actually taking melanin injections to look darker. And the last point that we have is, anything that has rapid effects will destroy your skin. Avoid products that says lighten you in 1 week. And this has to go for soaps, for scrubs, for masks, for body lotions, body creams, serums that are lightening agent. Anything that will make you light in 1 week, drop it. Because when you want to repair your skin, it will take at least 2 years. I know people who have damaged their skin and it's taking them like 5 years, because they keep trying to go back to use more bleaching products to help lighten the part that has been hyperpigmented or that has been discolored or that has changed color due to these harmful products. And when they do it, the skin becomes thinner. In fact, the situation gets worse. Don't use a lightening product to lighten a damaged skin. Whether you have eczema, psoriasis, whether you have a discoloration, hyperpigmentation, sunburn, don't use a lightening product to lighten an already damaged skin. Is very dangerous. You worsen the situation. And that is what most manufacturers are recommending for people. And those who do this manufacturing at the back of their house, this is what they are doing. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your questions. Thank you so much for commenting and sharing and increasing the visibility of this channel. I remain your seasoned medical professional, Gwendolyn Halle. Bye-bye.